92 people now confirmed dead in the landslide-hit Philippine province of Davao de Oro. Responders push on with their search and retrieval operations as 36 remain missing. Some victims were buried at the Mawab Public Cemetery. 17 unidentified remains affected by decomposition were also temporarily buried for health and sanitation reasons. The Education Department says it's not opposed to a bill seeking to raise the minimum monthly salary of teachers to 50,000 pesos. But Deputy Spokesperson Francis Bringa said lawmakers should also take into consideration the fiscal space and budget allotted to the agency. He adds any salary increase should not disrupt the staffing pattern in the whole education sector. The DepEd's also engaged with the World Bank, to study the percentage of a doable salary increase for teachers in the Philippines. IT company Accenture sees generative artificial intelligence improving operational efficiency by up to 40%. Accenture says generative AI has helped drive speed to market and cost efficiency in various companies worldwide. It adds more enterprises are using AI to improve the strategic implementation of day-to-day operations. Accenture is currently helping companies move through generative AI's maturity spectrum.
We are going through now a hype cycle and we are going to come back and settle down. It's been a year that enterprises are trying out generative AI and the implementation within the organization. We now see it's coming down to real applications, real applicability, looking at the data, looking at the data consistency, and making sure that, you know, you apply responsible AI components to make sure your generative AI doesn't result in bias, generative AI doesn't give you wrong responses when you are talking to an AI engine. So organizations are getting there.
The European Internal Revenue Bureau issues a clarification on its cross-border service tax rule after business groups called for the policy's revocation. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Andrea Taguines. Hi, Andy.
Good afternoon, Stanley. You're right. The BIR clarified that its taxation policy on cross-border services will be implemented on a case-to-case basis. BIR Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. said that those who will be covered by the revenue regulation will be determined during the auditing process. So he said that this doesn't mean that everyone is automatically liable and that it will depend on what happens during the auditing process. His remarks come after some of the biggest business groups in the Philippines asked the BIR to scrap Revenue Memorandum Circular 5-2024, which imposes a 25% withholding tax and 12% final withholding VAT on cross-border services or services to a Philippine entity that are performed by a foreign entity. In a joint statement, the business group said that imposing these taxes will raise the cost of doing business in the Philippines and may drive foreign investors away from the country. But according to Lumagi, they're only applying the Supreme Court decision. The memo had cited this high court's ruling on a certain case which stated that the satellite airtime fee payments by the company Aces Philippines, a domestic corporation, to Aces Bermuda, a non-resident foreign corporation, is subject to final withholding tax. But the business groups noted that the factors present in the Aces case are not necessarily applicable in other cross-border services like consultancy firms. So again, Lumagi reiterated that this revenue regulation will depend on the kind of service that's being rendered, and it will not be implemented on like a blanket case. Among the signatories of the letter are the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and the Philippine Exporters Confederation. Meanwhile, Stanley, the Tax Bureau is also not keen on deferring the imposition of a 1% withholding tax on the sales made by online sellers. See, according to FinTech Alliance, some of its members, particularly digital financial service providers who will be doing the actual deduction of the withholding tax, said that they need more time to to update their operating systems and modify their agreements with online merchants to be able to implement this new regulation as seamlessly as possible. But Commissioner Lumagi pointed out that under the revenue regulation, they still have until April to actually make the necessary adjustments. So he said it would be premature to talk about any extension right now. He also emphasized the need to start imposing taxes on online transactions immediately because of the huge revenue loss the government is facing because of their non-compliance to tax regulations. Stanley.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Andrea Taguines.